I'm Sarah.
Hi, Rachel.
Nice to meet you.
My name is Rachel. I'm from Yardley, Pennsylvania. I'm a very extravagant person. I like to be over and beyond. Today I brought my mom, my future mother-in-law.
Hi.
My sister, and then a couple of my bridesmaids.
Any designers in particular that kind of stuck out at you?
Pnina. I'm very extravagant.
Pnina's designs are the ultimate fantasy wedding dress. Her dresses start minimum $5,000 and can go all the way up to $50,000.
And is there a price point we'd like to be around or under, roughly?
$10,000 or under.
Okay. Where are you comfortable keeping it around?
Three or under.
Three or under.
That's me.
Okay.
I have no control.
Okay.
She wanted to be around 10. I want to be around 3. So it's a big price difference.
With a $7,000 difference, Sarah's still confused about the budget.
So your budget, is there like a middle ground? I mean...
No.
No. That's what she's telling me, then I have to listen to her because I don't know.
Everybody is pitching in towards the dress.
Her fiance, Kenny, I have a feeling he will give her the money to buy it. My fiance's name is Kenny. Kenny is the perfect guy for me because he's always putting others before himself. My fiance, he's gonna find a way. He always tells me this is why I work so hard, is to get you the things that you want.
She pretty much shouts and he's right there to do what she wants. He's a saint. I like the color.
Yeah, I like the color.
That's it. That's all I like.
You don't like anything else?
I don't like anything else.
Like
The most opinionated person is definitely my mom.
But I like how nice and tight it is. I like the ruching on the
fabric.
And you
like that beading? It looks like Catwoman.
What?
It's not you. It's not you.
No. Mm-hmm. I like the whole shape of it, though.
So far, Mom's not dazzled by the pricey Pnina. Rachel is showing off another sexy silhouette that doesn't come cheap. Mom doesn't love the Pnina look or the Pnina price.
I do not like this top part at all.
You don't like the top?
Really?
I actually really like the plunge.
It's very similar to the one you just had on.
Well, it's the same designer, too.
I think she's had her mindset coming in here that she only wanted Pnina, and I think her family thought that maybe when she was here, she'd change her mind.
I like it.
Pnina's dresses are high-ticket items.
She wants, and she's very much about grandeur, and I don't have much control over her.
Rachel's ignoring her mother's $3,000 budget by trying on another Pnina crystal confection.
Wow. Wow. Look at the hoop.
Can-can.
Oh, my God. Talk about can-can.
Yeah.
I love that, Rachel.
Like, that's right. See that? I love the back.
That's gorgeous.
That's you.
It's definitely
you. That is gorgeous.
So pretty. Rachel Grace.
What?
Price.
I don't know. I don't know.
You just try on dresses willy-nilly and you don't ask how much?
No. It's expensive because it's Pnina.
What do you think about it, Rach?
I like the top. I don't like the bottom. This goes out way too much.
But that's you, baby, too much.
Well, what if it looked like the bottom of the last dress you had on?
If it looked like the bottom of the last dress, then yeah.
This is the skirt I'm thinking she's thinking with that bodice.
Okay, we can do that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Sarah and Pnina are trying to mix and match gowns, which will put Rachel even more in the red.
Rachel really doesn't have a clear picture of what she's going to be able to spend on her dress. And already she's looking at a custom Pnina Tornai gown, which is going to start at around $9,000, $10,000. So this is really a recipe for disaster.
But you tried this dress on, right?
Uh-huh.
And you like the silhouette of that.
Right. But I love the pleats.
Well, you're not going to have it on that bottom.
I know, that's the thing. So maybe we could take more of the stuff out underneath here.
And keep the box pleats.
Yes.
Okay. Now Rachel's saying that maybe she just wants everything taken out of here because she loves the box pleats.
Oh, then just do that.
I'm pulling in this hoop skirt, trying to get Rachel to envision it, how it's going to be when it's without this big poofy skirt attached to it.
Rachel, what are you feeling? Are you feeling like a stuffed sausage? You know what?
I love it.
What is she doing to me?
Oh my God.
Trying to crawl out, and she keeps throwing the dress on me. Help!
She's killing me.
She threw me under her skirt.
Now the bride must make up her mind.
Is this your dress?
I don't
What's your hesitation?
If Kenny's gonna like it.
I really think it would have been better if Rachel had spoken to her fiance before so that at the end of the appointment, she would be really clear on what she could and couldn't spend.
Even if Rachel loves the $9,200 dress, it's three times more than her mother is willing to spend.
Even the $3,000 that's my price point is pushing it.
Rachel calls a dressing room detente to discuss who might come up with the $6,200 difference.
So what are your thoughts?
I really like it.
Do you like it enough that you wanna buy it? Then you've gotta think of what you're gonna do. You know how much I'm good for. I'm not paying right. 10 grand for a dress. And I know you don't expect me to, but have right. you thought about if you found a dress that you just love, what were you planning yeah. on doing?
Yeah.
What were you planning on doing?
Why? Okay, Mom, you wanna go out?
Yeah. I think she was almost hoping that her future mother-in-law would pipe up and say, I'll pay the difference.
I feel overwhelmed with everything. I know this is the dress for me, but I just need to talk to my fiance just to make sure this is it. Let's do it.
If you start trying on dresses outside your budget, you're gonna leave our salon heartbroken.
Rachel heads home empty-handed.
Welcome to Kleinbau, and congratulations.
My name is Melissa Pombrand. I'm getting married in less than 2 months. I don't even know if it's possible to get a dress, so I just showed up today keeping my fingers crossed that we can make it happen.
You're getting married very soon,
March 27th.
Oh my goodness.
We would have liked to have gotten married in the fall, but because of family schedules, that wasn't gonna happen.
How are you envisioning yourself on your wedding day?
That's kind of the problem because I envision one end of the spectrum all the way to the other. I have no idea. The wedding is gonna be in my parents' backyard. My fiance's name is Annie Jacobs. I know that God put him on this earth to be with me, and he's just perfect for me in every sense.
And is there a price point that we want to be respectful of?
About $1,500 to $2,000, which I'm a little nervous about okay. because I know that really limits my choices.
My suggestion to you would be to look at our stock or sample pieces,
okay.
something that you could take home with you today. How does that sound?
That sounds good.
She really doesn't know what she wants. She has a limited budget, and she has a very short time frame to get this dress. This is a challenge, even for a veteran consultant like Camille.
Melissa's dress is totally different from what I thought, but the dress totally brings out Melissa's beauty.
At the end of the day, I have people pulling me every direction. I see Camille kind of needing me to help put a little sparkle into this appointment. A little something for the hair?
Yes.
Okay. So I come in and put on this headpiece, and I think it kind of helps seal the whole deal.
Look at you.
Look, it's working. It's working. I knew that if she cried, that she could see me and envision me walking down the aisle in that dress, and that's what I was looking for.
Mom seals the deal with a sentimental accessory.
Oh, there you go.
Oh, we have something perfect.
That
here.
Is like perfect. Oh.
Oh, I think now the bride's gonna cry. Oh, that could be your something bar.
Melissa, I feel like it's perfect.
So, Melissa.
Yes.
Is this your dress?
This is my dress.
Are we yes. saying yes? Okay, congratulations.
Thank you.